Quick word on yesterday's post on leadership, and what it had to do with was we were talking about how if you are somebody who's a parent, administrator, a team captain, a coach, and you give appraisal to things, and if it's not 100% the truth, then how that's not effective. And this is where some people get some confusion. It's not about being negative. It's also not about just being positive when positive isn't necessarily something that was indicated from somebody's actions. So if somebody hasn't earned something, my point is don't just throw something on top of it, some sugar, and expect that it's going to help something grow. What's going to grow is what you illuminate through your words. So and this is where there's some confusion out there with positive coaching. There's a positive coaching alliance and all this other stuff. Okay, positive coaching, again, is not coddling somebody. It's not anything, you know, you need to read the different books that are out there on grit and the growth mindset and really get clear on how to be a positive coach that is an honest positive coach, because lying these days is acceptable as long as it's politically correct. So we see coaches out there and everybody's got an excuse and everybody means well, but when you tell somebody good job and they didn't do their best, and this is where I love the whole, you're at an event and you hear, listen, you know, everybody behave themselves and the playing field is an extension of the classroom, which is one of my all-time quotes to really repurpose what is or isn't going on as it relates to, okay, is that about us as a fan or a parent? And or is that also about the coaches and the athletes? Because if it's an extension of the classroom, and you hear people with the positive coaching stuff, they're like, well, you know, don't be negative. Well, when a teacher hands back a test, aren't there marks on that when they got something wrong? I mean, the point is to get better and to improve. And so it's important, yes, you do have to say what they're doing well, but you also need to let them know what they need to improve on. And if you don't have a test, if you don't have these little exams along the way, they have no way to track their progress. And if they're actually trying to get better and not just going out and having fun, which we just need to get clear on that, if varsity sports is about getting ready for the next level, then it's about growth. And growth has to do with correcting mistakes and also daring to put yourself out there to make mistakes, but also improving along the way and working on your technique, which means there would be homework, there would be video review, there would be little mini practices, there might be extra credit sessions, there might be sessions where you can get extra group help. That doesn't necessarily happen too often in too many programs. The programs that are out there where that does happen, you see, because they have sustained success, and year after year after year, no matter talent goes up, talent goes down, they still have sustained success. So it's very important to understand. I'm not talking about being negative. You know, you have to encourage the positive. You have to know the upside, but you also need to know what your downside is, and you need to know how to make those corrections. And it's not very helpful for a kid to hear that they did a great job when they didn't do a great job. Maybe they had a good effort while they're on the field, but what did they do to prepare? I mean, preparation is very important. I mean, if you're not prepared to succeed, it's going to be difficult to succeed. So get real clear and be honest. You don't have to be brutal with, you know, the student athletes you're working with, but you do have to be honest. Give them feedback that's actionable too. Don't tell them something that's very vague. Don't give them a cookie cutter response. I mean, if you say that you're going to coach, then let's coach. I mean, let's coach them up. Like, put yourself out there. There are several coaches that call me up and ask questions about, hey, why did you send this? Why did you have this person do this? Ask questions. I'm not going to take it personally. Now, if you ask the same question four times because you're not paying attention, you're not taking notes, and you're not putting it into practice, I'm going to get a little upset, and I'm going to get tired of sitting there and dealing with somebody who's really not interested in improving. But you don't have that very often. So if you're asking questions forward, ask your student athletes questions. Ask them why they did this or what they're thinking, and create an opportunity to have a coaching moment and really get that person thinking, get them interested, invested, and then get them moving forward. And so once again, just to restate this, don't tell a kid, you know, great job, you were awesome, like super talented, whatever. Talk about the work that they could put into it. Give them some things they can work on. Tell them some things that they can actually start doing immediately to take, you know, positive action moving forward. The whole Positive Coaching Alliance is not about being politically correct. It's not about patting somebody on the back that didn't do their best effort on something. It's about teaching them how they can do something better than they're doing it currently and moving forward from that standpoint. And it's really important to understand that along the way, you're probably gonna have some points where you get frustrated. It's normal, and so does the student athlete. At the same time, don't just constantly put the blame back on somebody. We've had kids come back and they say, well, you know, I asked coach what I could do, and they don't really get much feedback. Oh, you're doing well. You know, or like they try to look at the team and say, hey, what could we do as a team? You know, because we always try to get people to be leaders. So it's like, okay, what can the team do better? What can we do? And all too often, what happens is the coach misunderstands where the kid's coming from, and they assume, because they don't ask the question, they assume that the kid's pointing blame on other people, when in order to be a great team leader, you have to rally the troops. You have to get everybody to be accountable. You have to look at every area where you can possibly improve and try to improve individually and also as a team. And when everybody wants to be accountable and is looking to increase their performance, then everybody gets on the same page, everybody improves, you get that team chemistry that people talk about. But more importantly, at the end of the year, everybody has made progress. People have been accountable. They've had ups, they've had downs, they've had victories, they've had losses, but they know in the end they're gonna survive it, and more importantly, they're gonna be better because of it. And then as they move forward, whether it's the next sports season or whether it's the next level, maybe they're moving on to college, they've learned through that process. They're prepared to fail and they can deal with it. And they also know how to use that failure to increase their success in the future because they know how to break it down. They know how to look at it. You can't just spill milk and then walk past it and pretend it's not there and expect it's going to get cleaned up. It also doesn't help you with not spilling it the next time either. So the coaches that are out there ignoring stuff, please don't do that. Stop doing that. It is not helpful. And when somebody breaks a rule, bring it to their attention. Have them be accountable to the team and restate why they're on the team. A lot of people are doing things for social reasons. That's fine. Everybody wants instant gratification. You need to delay the gratification, just like they say, you know, in all the Spartan podcasts, and be willing to put in the work. And track your progress. See what you're doing, what you're not doing. Ask your coach for more coaching. 99% of the coaches I know, if you ask them for more help, they're happily going to roll up their sleeves and say, yeah, absolutely. When do you want help? You know, today, after practice, you know, whenever. They'll set something up. And with the use of technology these days, it's incredible the kind of productivity that you can make and the kind of improvements you can make along the way. And if you get better, and other people seeing you progress, and then they start asking you questions, that kid that maybe didn't want to do the film work before, maybe they start realizing, hey, you know what, maybe there's something to being, you know, a little bit more critical about my performance to see where I can make improvements. Because if you're not looking at your performance, it's impossible to really sustainably improve over the course of time, because eventually you're going to get to that ceiling where, like, without the film review, you're kind of at a standstill. And you can guess how you performed out there, but until you watch it, it's very difficult to try to really know everything that you did. I'll often have kids that are like, oh, I didn't do that. And we sit down and tell them, like, Coach Kutry, yeah, I did do that. I'm sorry. You know, it's not about apologizing. I hate it when kids say, I'm sorry. I don't like those two words stuck together. Sorry just rings up, you know, it's kind of... Usually it's not honest. They're not apologizing. You know, they just want to be done with it. But like, let's get clear on what happened. Let's move forward. And again, you don't need to apologize as much as it is just being accountable to yourself so that you can actually make progress. So hopefully that was helpful and clarified things on the leadership talk yesterday. And if you need more information, reach out to coaches. They're there to help.